If you are a highly sensitive person, HSP, life can feel like it's spinning out of control. Fast. According to research, the HSPs process all forms of stimulation deeply due to a biological difference in their nervous system. Seemingly, little things that don't bother other people sometimes completely overtake you. And what may be a minor irritation to some might make your palms sweat, upset your stomach, or quickly zap your energy. In this video, I will share with you 9 things only highly sensitive people will understand. If you're one of our great fans who have been wanting to know who is behind this channel, now you can know. Kindly check the description box to join Steve Courage's personal channel, learn directly from him, or ask him any questions. Thanks. 1. Other people's emotions. Do you have that friend whom, no matter how much you try to mask your pain, still senses that all is not well with you? At times, you may even wonder how come they can see through you. Well, that shows you have a sensitive friend. Sensitive people are not just emotional beings themselves, but they also pick up on others' changes in mood quickly. When they meet up with a friend, they can immediately tell how their day was, how they're feeling, and how the rest of the day will go with just a glance at their facial expression and body language. Being able to detect these mood changes in others is partly the reason highly sensitive people get so offended when others don't understand. They're offended at you because they expect that since they can sense when this is wrong, other people ought to be able to do that too. 2. Gestures. Do you know that 2 individuals can converse without saying a word? Well, that is possible only if the individuals involved are highly sensitive. Highly sensitive people can decode not only statements but actions and body language easily. They can know people's intents by just looking at them. Even though you try to pretend, they know when you are indirectly trying to pass a message or insult them. Highly sensitive people notice little things that others miss, even when it affects other people. They see when someone's tone of voice doesn't match their words. They notice when someone won't meet their eyes when answering a question, and they may find themselves agonizing over the interaction afterward, especially if they suspect the other person wasn't being sincere. 3. Empathy. Highly sensitive individuals are very empathetic. Not only are they quick to pick up other people's emotional cues, but you often let their emotions dictate your own. Sensitive individuals can manage their feelings and also help other people to handle their feelings. A typical sensitive individual finds it hard not to feel down when others are. So when a friend comes to them with a problem, they take their mood on yourself as well. When it comes to decision making, highly sensitive individuals tend to always put themselves in others' shoes to better understand the situation and make the best possible choice. 4. Loud noise. Does the thought of a party or going to a busy bar for the big game sound kind of terrible to you? If yes, you might be a highly sensitive person. Highly sensitive persons get easily overwhelmed with their large crowds and lots of commotion events like concerts, going clubbing, or festivals. Although going out may be the popular idea of fun, it is not so for highly sensitive individuals. For highly sensitive individuals, going out might sound like a direct path to a personal shutdown. They would rather stay indoors to recharge. So, if you're not an HSP, but someone you know is, they're not a Debbie Downer. They're practicing self-preservation. 5. Lack of sleep. It does not matter whether or not you are a highly sensitive person. Life can be tiring for everyone, and we all feel worn out from time to time. Sleep is like an escape route. It is a way we use to rest from a tiring day and prepare ourselves for the next struggle. However, due to their depth of processing, highly sensitive people may need more sleep than others. Scientific research says that most highly sensitive persons need at least 8 hours, and many of them sleep for over the average of 9 or 10 hours nightly. When they don't get that sleep, they miss a significant opportunity to rest and reset their ramped-up senses. Lack of sleep will cause a highly sensitive person to burn out and edge towards depression, anxiety, and become less capable of functioning. For a highly sensitive person, Running on a little shut eye can feel like the very definition of hell. Every minor irritation and inconvenience is ratcheted up exponentially. 6. Emotional exhaustion. Anyone ever told you that you are an emotional roller coaster? Do you have mixed feelings about it? Because it also exhausts you. A key characteristic of being a highly sensitive person is that you feel things more deeply and intensely than others. There is always a rush of emotions from your end, which most times cause you to be exhausted. One moment you are happy, and the next minute you may see someone who is sad and become sad too. This frequent absorption and reflection of other people's emotions, especially if you are out all day, can feel like you are on an emotional roller coaster. 7. Moving on. Does a breakup from 3 months ago still sting like yesterday? Still bitter and hurt over being backstabbed 5 years ago? Do you feel weird about it? Well, you are okay, and it's not strange. It's just high sensitivity. One of the most painful downsides to being so sensitive is that you could have difficulty letting go of emotional pain, whether you received it from an insult or breakup. It just tends to linger with you. You know at the back of your mind that it is not a big deal, but you can't help making it one anyway. Even though you try to push it away, a little reminder could cause you to burst into a fresh rush of emotions. Even if a highly sensitive person finally moves on, there is a tendency that the past hurt will affect the other relationships they get into. 8. Pressure. Ever heard someone saying, "I work well under pressure," or "pressure makes me do better"? The chances are that people who strive under pressure are not highly sensitive persons. Deadlines and similar types of time pressure can cause severe distress to a highly sensitive person and make them sabotage the entire activity they are carrying on. Highly sensitive individuals hate having to rush into anything and juggling several tasks at once. They like to do things at their own pace without any pressure. Due to their perfectionist nature, they want to complete tasks only when they know it's perfect. Highly sensitive persons are much more content taking their time with their projects and giving their full singular focus to whatever they're doing. 9. Taking criticism to heart. A non-HSP may be able to use their thinking brain, neocortex, the part that handles logic, to not take criticism personally at the moment. But for highly sensitive people, even when they logically know that criticism is invalid, they still need to process the emotions that arise. For highly sensitive people, emotional reactions are wired deeply into their brains. So, when every negative feedback they receive is rooted in their emotional brain, it bypasses their thinking mind. The bypass is the reason why highly sensitive people take criticism as a personal attack on their worth as a human being. Unfortunately, doing so only serves to block them from improving their skills and abilities, because they let the criticism get too deep to the extent that it makes them doubt themselves. It is essential to use constructive criticism as it's meant to be taken, rather than a personal affront to your abilities. Take the criticism as advice rather than insult, and you'll be able to focus on improving that aspect of your performance in the future. As a result of deep processing, HSPs tend to get mentally overloaded quicker than non-HSPs and also face challenges and misunderstandings that come with it. However, being an HSP is normal. It is not a disorder or a malfunction. If you're one of our great fans who have been wanting to know who is behind this channel, now you can know. Kindly check the description box to join Steve Courage's personal channel. Learn directly from him or ask him any questions. Thanks.